These days, Cecilia Neuhaus still grows roses, but on a much smaller scale than in her former garden.
The other garden, you know, was almost overwhelming, you know, for one person. You know, it was 2 acres, 780 some rose bushes, and I felt that I didn't have too much of a life other than taking care of all those rose bushes.
In 2009, she and husband Russell built a new home where Cecilia's pared down her gardens to savor them rather than be their daily taskmaster.
In this garden, I really wanted, you know, as I'm getting older, I can't lug 50-pound sacks of cornmeal, you know, or alfalfa meal around with me. So I wanted it to be just a refuge, you know, still have, you know, allow me to play and work in it and at a more reasonable level, but to provide a lot more enjoyment that took care of itself.
The home and garden's design inspiration sprung from family trips to Venice.
I was really captivated by the Venetian Gothic portion of the 800 years of architecture. That's the one that appealed the most to me.
Their love of the Grand Canal in Venice found its version in the Lake Austin site they picked for their new home. Architect Charles Travis captured historic Venetian architecture with a view to Texas lifestyle. Landscape architect Tait Moring combines Cecilia's low-maintenance needs with water-wise plants that complement but don't compete with the architecture or the view to the water.
In Venice, everything is connected by the canals, and the only transportation besides walking is boats. So most people's front doors are actually facing the water. So we wanted to create kind of an open, welcoming feeling along this canal.
And it's very calming. Everybody, you know, really relaxes when they come here. And I find myself refreshed every day when I come up and look at the water feature. It's just, I think, one of those things about water, and especially when it's a calm water like it is today, it just soothes the soul, as they say.
The architect created so many great spaces just to sit and reflect.
Tait's design reflects that intention. His respect for divine structure found a kinship in Italy's gardens.
A lot of the gardens, even though they're ancient and kind of overgrown, if you look closely, most of them have a real structure to them, sort of a formal geometry. And then because they're so old and kind of overgrown, they have a much looser feel. But if you really look close, you can see the definite paving patterns and a lot of really great geometry.
In Italy or Texas, no garden is complete without fragrance, like the patio's white camellias. Young grapevines will soon cover a patio arbor, a cue from gardeners everywhere to grow food wherever they can. On upper patios, Cecilia relies on containers for fragrance and butterfly attraction.
Here, just like in Venice, the water table is really high, so if you can't build up the soil, then one thing that you can do is grow things in containers.
Below, a narrow strip reminiscent of Italian walled gardens includes edibles like pomegranates and bay laurel. It leads to the Bellini Terrace for the head-on view of their Grand Canal.
When we first started walking the lot before the house was built, there was a hillside over there which was overgrown and had a lot of rubble from where the bridge was built and was overgrown with Bermuda grass. But we did notice that it had a great view down the canal, so we decided to terrace that. And since we had had a few Bellinis when we were in Venice, we decided to name that the Bellini Terrace, and we've since christened it with some Bellini just recently.
When I go to the Bellini Terrace and then look down the canal, it's almost like I'm back there, although I'm in the middle of the city.
In front, long lines complement the architecture. Evergreen structure formalizes seasonal spills of color. Favorite gathering spot is the axis where all paths meet.
And the paving pattern is something that we had seen in Venice.
The secret walled gardens of Venice influence niches for protected tropicals. Designed to also be viewed from indoors, the windows form one wall of an interior passageway. On the opposite side, the windows open to the patio courtyard view.
When I walk from the main part of the house over to the master, which is there's that connecting passageway with the windows on both sides, I always stop and look, and I count my blessings, and I see the seasons come and go. We had a little bit of snow this winter, so it was lovely to look at it in that season. It's nice to see it in the spring when the new shoots come out. It's a never-changing window. Actually, literally, there are two windows, and they're always changing and always providing delights. Even though I'm not carting around, you know, huge sacks of fertilizers and wheelbarrows anymore, I still take great delight in the senses, you know, and just the beauty of what my eyes can see and what feeds my soul.